Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ, I sermonize.
奉主耶稣圣名开始正道。
Today we will be studying 1 Kings chapter 7.
今天我们会来学列王记上第七章。
And I would also like to share the topic, serve like oxen.
我也想要来借此来分享一个题目，叫做服事如牛。
Let's all turn to 1 Kings chapter 7.
我们一同翻到列王记上第七章。
1 Kings chapter 7.
列王记上第七章。
This chapter can be divided into four sections.
这一章可以被分为四个部分。
The first section is from verse 1 to 12.
第一个部分是从一节到十二节。
In this passage, we learn that Solomon took 13 years to build his own house.
那在这一段里面，我们学到所罗门他用了十三年来为自己建造宫室。
And other than his own house.
不单单是他自己的公室。
He also built other buildings.
他也建了其他的建筑。
In verse 2, he built the house of the forests of Lebanon.
在第二节里面说到他建造了黎巴嫩林宫。
In verse 6, he built the hall of pillars.
在第六节里面说到他建造了有柱子的廊子。
In verse 7, he built the hall of judgment.
在第七节里面他建造了设立审判的廊子。
And in verse 8, he also built a house for the daughter of Pharaoh.
在第八节里面，他又为法老的女儿建造了一个宫。
The second section of this chapter is from verse 13 to 39.
那第二个部分呢，就是从本章的十三节到三十九节。
In this section, we are introduced to Huram, the craftsman.
在这一段里面，我们学到了这个巧匠户兰。
He was a highly skilled bronze worker.
他是一个技艺精湛的铜匠。
And Solomon sent for him to do his work for the temple.
那所罗门就让他来做这个圣殿里的工作。
From verses 15 to 22, Huram made two bronze pillars.
从十三节，从十五节到二十一节，他造了两根铜柱。
From verses 23 to 26, he made something called the sea and the oxen.
从二十六节到二十三节到二十六节，他建造了一个东西，叫做铜海和铜牛。
And from verses 27 to 39, he made something called the carts and the lavers.
在二十七节到三十九节里面记载着他造了一个洗濯盆和盆座。
The third section of this chapter is from verses 40 to 47.
那第四个部分是从四十到四十四十到四十七节。
This is a summary of all the things that Huram made with bronze.
这一段里面记载了户兰所造的圣殿的设备。
And the final section of this chapter is from verse 48 to 51.
那最后一个部分是从四十八节到五十一节。
In this last part of the chapter, Solomon had all the gold furnishings made for the house of the Lord.
那在这一段里面记载了所罗门为圣殿所造的所有的金器。
For today's sermon, I would like to focus our attention on something that Huram the craftsman made for the temple.
那在今天的讲道中，我想要重点关注在户兰所建造的一个东西上。
Let's read verses 23 to 26.
我们来读二十三节到二十六节。
Verse 23.
二十三节。
And he made the sea of cast bronze, 10 cubits from one brim to the other. It was completely round. Its height was 5 cubits.And a line of 30 cubits measured its circumference. Below its brim were ornamental buds encircling it all around, 10 to a cubit, all the way around the sea. The ornamental buds were cast in two rows when it was cast. It stood on 12 oxen, 3 looking toward the north, 3 looking toward the west, 3 looking toward the south, and 3 looking toward the east. The sea was set upon them, and all their back parts pointed inward.It was a handbreadth thick, and its brim was shaped like the brim of a cup, like a lily blossom, it contained 2,000 baths. In this passage, Huram made the sea and the oxen.
在这一段里面，户兰建造打造了铜海和铜牛。
The question is, what was the sea and the oxen?
那问题是这个铜海和铜牛是什么呢？
And what was it used for?
它是用来做什么的呢？
Firstly, the sea was a giant bowl made from bronze.
那这个首先这个铜海就是用铜建造的一个像碗一样的东西。
The distance from one side of the brim to the other was 5 meters.
那从一侧的边缘到另一侧的边缘有15米。
The height of it was 2.5 meters.
哦，不好意思，有五米，高度有2.5米。
And the circumference of it was approximately 15 meters around.
那它的围大概有15米。
Along with the sea, Huram also made the oxen.
那在跟这个一起呢，忽然还打造了铜牛。
The oxen was the base or the stand that held the giant bronze bowl.
那这个牛就是底部，就是这个支架，支撑着这个巨大的铜碗。
The oxen are 12 bronze statues cast in the shape of oxen.
这个牛有12只，就是雕刻成牛的形状。
3 face the north, 3 face the west, 3 face the south, and 3 face the east.
三只向北，三只向西，三只向南，三只向东。
The oxen were positioned back to back and they faced outwards.
那这些牛呢，它是背对背，脸朝外。
So if we can visualize it.
所以如果我们可以在脑子里想象一下它。
The sea and the oxen was a giant bronze bowl.
那这个铜海和铜牛它是一个巨大的铜碗。
It was full of water and it was set up on top of 12 statues of oxen.
那它装满了水，它就放在十二只公牛的雕像上。
Before priests can offer burnt offerings on the altar.
那在祭司到祭坛去献祭之前。
God commands that the priests must wash their hands and their feet.
神要求祭司呢必须先洗手洗脚。
Therefore the sea and the oxen were for the priests to wash in.
那所以这个铜海和铜牛就是祭司洗手洗脚的地方。
And every time that they would go to wash themselves.
那每一次他们进去之前就必须要先洗净自己。
We can imagine that they can't avoid the oxen beneath the sea.
那我们就可以想象，他们免不了要看到这个铜海底下的牛。
Every time they prepared themselves to serve God.
那每一次他们预备自己来侍奉神的时候
，They saw the oxen.
他们就看见这个牛。
What can we learn from this today?
从这个我们今天可以学到什么呢
？Before we serve God in the church.
在我们在教会服事之前
，We also need to wash ourselves.
我们必须先洁净自己。
And washing ourselves is connected to the oxen.
那洁净自己又跟这个牛有关系。
By meditating on the characteristics of oxen.
我们来思想牛的品质。
We prepare ourselves to serve God in the right way.
我们要以正确的方式来预备自己来侍奉神。
The question is, what are the characteristics of oxen?
那问题就是这个牛它是有什么品质呢？
When we think about oxen, we might simply think that it's an ordinary cow or bull.
当我们想到牛的时候，我们可能会想是普通的公牛。
However, there are 3 specific characteristics which define oxen.
但是在英文中的 oxen 它有几个特征。
Firstly, oxen are over 4 years old.
第一，它是指四岁以上的公牛。
Secondly, oxen have been trained to work.
第二就是它必须要经过训练来用于劳作。
And thirdly, oxen are commonly castrated bulls.
第三个就是它是指那些被阉割过的公牛。
Within these 3 details, we can glean some spiritual teachings to apply in our service today.
那从这些我们可以学到一些属灵的教训，并运用在我们今天的侍奉当中。
Firstly, oxen are over 4 years old.
第一点就是这个牛是要超过四岁的公牛。
This means that oxen are mature.
那这就意味着说这个是成熟的公牛。
Therefore, if we want to serve God, we also need to be mature.
所以当我们想要服事神的时候，我们自己也要变得成熟。
But what does it mean to be a mature?
但是成熟意味着什么呢
？Maturity can be someone who is ready to take on responsibility.
成熟的人就是那些已经准备好来承担责任的人。
Or someone mature is a person who is willing to put others before themselves.
就是那些愿意先考虑别人而不是考虑自己的人。
Being mature can also mean that we are emotionally balanced or we have a balanced personality.
成熟就意味着你情绪稳定，并且你人格健全。
There are many ways to define maturity from a worldly perspective.
从世界的角度来说，有很多来定义成熟的方成熟的方式。
But what does the Bible say?
但是圣经是怎么教导我们的呢？
Let's all turn to Philippians chapter 3.
我们来看腓立比书三章。
Philippians chapter 3 verses 13 to 15.
腓立比书三章十三到十五节。
Brethren, I do not count myself to have apprehended, but one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind, and reaching forward to those things which are ahead. I press toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. Therefore, let us, as many as are mature, have this mind. And if in anything you think otherwise, God will reveal even this to you. In this passage, Paul teaches us a mature mindset.
在这段经文里面，保罗教导我们成熟的心智。
In verse 15, Paul says, "If we are mature, let us have this mind."
在十五节里面说到，我们要存这样的心。
And in verse 13, Paul describes this mind mentioned in verse 15.
那他就在十五节里面提到了，这样的心是什么
？A mature mindset is one where we forget those things which are behind and reach forward to those things which are ahead.
那就是他要忘记背后，努力面前。
What Paul says here sounds like something that we would commonly hear in the world.
保罗这里所说的好像跟我们通常在世界上听到的差不多。
In the world, we often hear people say, "Don't let the past hold us back."
在这个世界上，我们可能经常会说，听到人家说不要沉溺于过去。
But when the world talks about the past, they are referring to past mistakes.
但是当这个世界说到过去的时候，它是指着过去的错误所说的。
What the world means is we shouldn't let our mistakes hold us back.
这个世界上所说的意思呢，是说我们不要困于过去的错误。
However, when Paul talks about forgetting those things which are behind,
但是当保罗说忘记背后的时候
，Paul is not talking about forgetting his mistakes.
保罗不是说忘记他的错误。
It's actually quite the opposite.
事实上刚好相反。
Instead, Paul is teaching us that we need to forget about the good works that we've done in the past.
相反，保罗是在教导我们要忘记我们过去所做的善行。
Let's read verses 7 and 8.
我们来读第七到第八节。
But what things were gained to me, these I have counted loss for Christ. Yet indeed I also count all things loss for the excellence of the knowledge of Christ Jesus my Lord, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things, and count them as rubbish, that I may gain Christ. In these verses, Paul tells us that he gave up all things so that he may gain Christ.
那在这里保罗说到他丢弃万事只为得着基督。
And although Paul has already done so much good for God,
那尽管保罗已经为神做了这么多的善事，
he refuses to let himself feel satisfied with these good works.
他没有因为这些所做的功就自满。
Paul refuses to let his past good works cloud his judgment.
保罗拒绝让他过去的善行来影响他自己的判断。
Let's read verse 12.
我们来读第十二节。
Verse 12.Not that I have already attained or am already perfected, but I press on, that I may lay hold of that for which Christ Jesus has also laid hold of me. In this verse, Paul is very clear in his mind about his own position.
那在这一节里面，保罗在他的心里非常清楚自己的位置。
He knows that he hasn't attained salvation yet.
他知道他还没有得着救恩。
Therefore, he needs to continuously improve in his faith and in his service to God.
因此，他需要继续努力改善自己的信仰以及对神的侍奉。
If we break down what defines a mature mindset, it can be explained in two parts.
那我们可以将成熟的心智拆分成两个部分来解释。
Firstly, we need to forget about our past good works.
那第一点就是我们要忘记过去的善行。
And secondly, we need to continuously improve.
第二点就是我们要持续改正。
The first question is, why do we need to forget about our past works, past good works?
那第一个问题就是我们为什么要忘记过去的善行？
Let's all turn to Luke chapter 18.
我们来看路加福音十八章。
Luke chapter 18, verses 9 to 14.
路加福音十八章九到十四节。
Verse 9. Also he spoke this parable to some who trusted in themselves, that they were righteous and despised others. Two men went up to the temple to pray, one a Pharisee and the other a tax collector. The Pharisee stood and prayed thus with himself, God, I thank you that I am not like other men.Extortioners, unjust, adulterers, or even as this tax collector. I fast twice a week. I give tithes of all that I possess. And the tax collector standing afar off would not so much as raise his eyes to heaven, but beat his breast, saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. I tell you, this man went down to his house justified rather than the other. For everyone who exalts himself will be humbled, and he who humbles himselfwill be exalted. In this passage, Jesus spoke a parable.
在这段经文里面，耶稣讲了一个比喻。
And he described the prayer of a Pharisee.
他描述了法利赛人的祷告。
In the prayer of the Pharisee, he despised others.
在法利赛人的祷告中，他藐视其他人。
He even judges the tax collector who was sincerely repenting before God.
他甚至论断那个在神面前真心悔改的税吏。
Then in verse 12, we learn the reason for the Pharisees' pride and self-righteousness.
那在十二节里面，我们就读到了这个法利赛人骄傲和自以为意的原因。
The Pharisee didn't forget about the good works that he's done in the past.
这个法利赛人他没有忘记自己以前所做的善行。
Instead, he boasts about everything that he's done.
相反，他吹嘘自己所做过的一切。
He fasts twice a week.
他一个礼拜进食两次。
And he gives tithes of all that he possesses.
那凡他所得的都捐上十分之一。
As a result, in verse 14, the Pharisee was not justified in the eyes of God.
那结果在十四节里面，这个法利赛人在神眼中不算为义。
This means that he is not righteous in the sight of God.
就是说在神看来他不算为义。
In this parable, we learn why we need to forget about our past good works.
那在这一段经文里面，我们就可以学到我们为什么要忘记过去的善行。
If we look too highly on the things that we've done in the past,
如果我们高看我们过去所做的。
And if we count everything that we've done like the Pharisee,
那如果我们像法利赛人一样紧紧牢牢记住我们做过的每一件事。
When we serve God, we will look down on our co-workers.
那当我们服事神的时候，我们就会低看我们的同工。
When we serve God, we will despise our brothers and sisters.
当我们服事神的时候，我们就会藐视我们的弟兄姐妹。
And when this happens, it only causes trouble in the church.
当这些发生的时候，它只会给教会带来麻烦。
The second question about a mature mindset is why do we need to continuously improve?
那成熟的心智第二点呢，就是为什么我们要不断的进步？
Let's all turn to 1 Corinthians chapter 14.
那我们翻到哥林多前书第一章十四节。
1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 12.
哥林多前书十四章十二节。
Verse 12.
十二节。
Even so, you, since you are zealous for spiritual gifts, let it be for the edification of the church that you seek to excel.In this verse, it talks about being zealous for spiritual gifts.
在这一节里面提到了要切慕属灵的恩赐。
In other words, it's talking about continuously improving in our faith and in our service.
那就是不断那就是要不断改善我们的信心和我们的侍奉。
But have we ever closely considered why we are trying to improve?
但我们有没有认真想过我们为什么要不断进步呢？
If we are trying to improve ourselves,To increase the value of our own lives.
如果我们想要来改善自己，是为了增加我们自己生命的价值。
And if we are only doing it because we want to appear holy and hardworking in front of our brothers and sisters.
那如果我们这样做只是为了想要在我们的弟兄姐妹面前表现得很圣洁、很殷勤做主公的样子，
then we are no better than the people in the world chasing status and wealth.
那我们就比那些在世界上追求地位和财富的人好不到哪里去。
In verse 12, it teaches us the reason for continuous improvement.
在十二节里面提到了要持续进步的原因。
The reason we want to continuously improve.
那些让我们想要不断进步的原因。
Or the reason we want to excel.
那些让我们想要超越的原因。
Should be for the edification of the church.
应该是为了要造就教会。
Therefore, when we serve God with a mature mindset,
因此当我们用成熟的心智来侍奉神时，
we forget those things which are behind, and we reach forward to those things which are ahead.
我们就忘记背后，努力面前。
We forget past good works to avoid causing trouble in the church.
我们忘记过去的善行，以免在教会中造成麻烦。
And we reach forward and continuously improve to edify the church.
我们努力面前，不断地来进步，来造就教会。
The second quality that defines oxen are that oxen are trained to work.
那这个英文中 oxen 这个词的第二个意思就是指那些经过训练被用于劳作的公牛。
The question is, how are oxen trained?
那这些牛是怎么被训练的呢？
Let's all turn to Acts chapter 9.
我们来看《使徒行传》第九章。
Acts chapter 9 verses 1 to 5.
《使徒行传》第九章一到五节。
Then Saul, still breathing threats and murder against the disciples of the Lord, went to the high priest and asked letters from him to the synagogues of Damascus, so that if he found any who were of the way, whether men or women, he might bring them bound to Jerusalem. As he journeyed, he came near Damascus, and suddenly a light shone around him from heaven.Then he fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? And he said, Who are you, Lord? Then the Lord said, I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. It is hard for you to kick against the goads. In this passage, it records Paul's conversion.
那在这一段经节里面记载了保罗归信的过程。
At the time, Paul was persecuting the Christians.
在那个时候保罗还是逼迫基督徒的。
And while he was on his way to Damascus to arrest more Christians,
那他在去往大马士革去逮捕更多的基督徒的路上，
Jesus spoke to Paul.
那耶稣就对保罗说话。
A light shone around him, he fell to the ground, and he heard a voice.
那一道光照向了他，他就扑倒在地，听见有声音对他说话。
When Jesus spoke to him, he said a phrase,That explains how oxen are trained.
当耶稣对他说话的时候，耶稣说了一句话，就可以用来解释公牛是怎么被训练的。
Jesus said, "It is hard for you to kick against the goads."
在第五节的最后，英文版里耶稣说了这样一句话：“你用脚踢刺是难的。”
What does this mean?
这意味着什么呢？
So a goad is a long stick with a pointed piece of iron on its tip.
那这里的刺指的是赶牛用的长棍，它的顶端有一个尖尖的铁刺。
This was used to poke the oxen while it was plowing the ground.
那过去在牛耕地的时候，他们就用这个刺来扎耕牛。
The farmer would poke the ox to steer it in the right direction.
农民用这个来扎牛，让这个牛来耕地，耕在正确的方向上。
But sometimes the ox would kick against the goad.
但是有些时候这个牛会来踢这个刺。
And as a result, the pointed piece of iron would go deeper and deeper into its flesh.
那结果呢，扎在牛身上的这个刺就会越扎越深。
Therefore, the more the ox would rebel,
那如果牛越反抗，
the more it would suffer.
它就会越痛。
So an ox that's trained to work is sensitive to the farmer's direction.
所以牛就被训练，它就可以知道农民想要让它耕种的方向。
If the farmer wants it to turn right, it will turn right.
那农民要叫它向右，它就向右。
And if the farmer wants it to turn left, it will turn left.
农民要叫它向左，它就向左。
The ox knows it will only suffer if it rebels against the farmer.
这个牛知道，如果违抗这个农民的意思，只会受苦。
Therefore, oxen that have been trained to work will follow the farmer's direction.
那所以呢，这个经过训练的公牛，它就会听从农民的指示。
So if God is the farmer and we are the ox.
所以神就好像这个农民，我们就好像这个公牛。
The question is, how do we follow God's direction?
我们要问的就是，我们要如何的跟从神的方向。
Let's go back to Acts chapter 9 and read verse 6.
那我们回到使徒行传第九章读第六节。
Verse 6.
第六节。
So he, trembling and astonished, said, Lord, what do you want me to do? Then the Lord said to him, Arise and go into the city, and you will be told what you must do. After Jesus spoke to Paul,
在耶稣对保罗说话之后，
Paul asked Jesus, Lord, what do you want me to do?
在英文版的圣经里面记载到，保罗就回答神说，回答耶稣说，主啊，我当怎样做？
Therefore, if we want to follow God's direction,
所以如果我们想要跟从神的方向，
we also need to ask God.
我们也必须要求问神。
And this asking refers to prayer.
那这里的求问就指的是我们的祷告。
However, just asking in prayer is not enough.
当然，只在祷告中求问是不够的。
We also need to have the right heart when we ask.
那我们求问的时候也要有一颗正确的心。
So when Paul asked Jesus, Lord, what do you want me to do?
所以当保罗问神，问耶稣说，主啊，我当怎样做？
What do you think Paul's heart was like when he said these words?
你觉得当保罗说这些话的时候，他的心是怎么样的？
At the time, Paul thought that he was serving God by persecuting the Christians.
那个时候，保罗以为他逼迫基督徒就是在服事神。
He wanted to do so much for God.
他想要为神做很多工。
He was even willing to make the long journey to Damascus.
他甚至愿意大老远地跑去大马士革。
But only now he understood that Jesus is God.
但是只有现在他才明白了耶稣是神。
Only now, Paul understood that instead of serving God, he was actually persecuting him.
直到现在，他才明白他不是在服事神，而是在逼迫神。
So with this context in mind,
所以当我们了解了这个背景，
Paul must have felt completely heartbroken.
那保罗肯定非常心碎。
Everything he believed in was wrong.
那他之前所信的全都是错的。
And his whole belief system was turned upside down.
那他的整个信仰系统都颠倒了。
So when Paul said these words,
所以当保罗说这些话的时候，
Lord, what do you want me to do?
在英文版圣经的第五节里面，保罗说，主啊，你想让我做什么？
We can understand that Paul truly meant these words from the bottom of his heart.
那我们知道保罗肯定是真心实意来说这些话的。
It's like he has completely surrendered to God.
他完全的顺服了神。
Paul no longer wants to do the things according to his own will.
保罗不再按照自己的旨意而行。
And all he wants now is to know the will of God.
他现在所有想做的就只是想知道神的旨意。
His entire being was ready to listen to what Jesus wanted him to do.
他已经完全准备好来听从耶稣的吩咐。
By embracing Paul's heart in this moment,
我们如果想象一下保罗这个时候的心情。
And by asking God what he wants us to do,
那我们就要问神他想要让我们做什么。
We can serve God like an ox that's trained to work.
那我们就可以像经过训练的公牛一样来侍奉神。
We can serve God by truly following His direction.
我们可以完全的遵照神的旨意，走在神所指示的方向上。
The third quality which defines oxen are that oxen are commonly castrated bulls.
那第三个品质就是指阉割过的公牛。
When a bull is castrated, it stops the production of testosterone.
当公牛经过阉割，它就停止分泌睾丸素。
So the bull will lose its aggressive nature.
那公牛就变得不再那么好斗。
Then the bull will be gentle and easy to work with.
那这个公牛就会变得温顺，配合工作。
Therefore, when we serve God, this teaches us that we also need to be gentle.
那这告诉我们，当我们服侍神的时候，我们也要变得温顺。
By serving God with gentleness, we serve with the right execution.
那我们温柔地侍奉神，我们就会做出正确的行动。
The question is, how do we serve God with gentleness?
那问题就是我们要怎样温顺地来服侍神。
Let's turn to James chapter 3.
我们来看雅各书第三章。
James chapter 3, verses 13 to 18.
雅各书第三章十三到十八节。
Verse 13. Who is wise and understanding among you? Let him show by good conduct that his works are done in the meekness of wisdom. But if you have bitter envy and self-seeking in your hearts, do not boast and lie against the truth. This wisdom does not descend from above, but is earthly, sensual, demonic. For where envy and self-seeking exist, confusion and every evil thing are there. But the wisdom that is from above is first pure,then peaceable, gentle, willing to yield, full of mercy and good fruits, without partiality and without hypocrisy. Now the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace by those who make peace. In this passage, it teaches us about two different kinds of wisdom.
在这段经文里面告诉了我们两种智慧。
There's demonic wisdom and the wisdom that is from above.
那就是属鬼魔的智慧和从上头来的智慧。
The first kind of wisdom is in verses 14 and 15.
那就是第一种，就是在十四到十五节里面记载的。
In these verses, it talks about demonic wisdom.
在十四到十五节里面记载了属鬼魔的智慧。
It tells us demonic wisdom is full of bitter envy.
那属鬼魔的智慧是充满了苦毒的嫉妒和纷争。
And demonic wisdom is also full of self-seeking.
那鬼魔的智慧也是追求自我。
When someone is full of this demonic wisdom, in verse 14, it teaches us that they will want to boast and lie.
那如果有一个人他充满了属鬼魔的智慧，在十四节里面就告诉我们，这些人他们就会自夸说谎。
And boasting and lying are connected to our speech.
那自夸和说谎是我们的言语上。
Therefore, demonic wisdom expresses itself through proud words.
那属鬼魔的智慧就会在我们骄傲的话语上显示出来。
Now let's look at the wisdom that is from above.
那现在让我们来看从上头来的智慧。
Let's read verses 17 and 18.
我们来读十七到十八节。
But the wisdom that is from above is first pure, then peaceable, gentle, willing to yield, full of mercy and good fruits.Without partiality and without hypocrisy. Now the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace by those who make peace. The wisdom that is from above, or heavenly wisdom, is full of all kinds of good things.
那这个从上头来的智慧，或者说属天的智慧，就是和平。
It's pure, peaceable, gentle, and willing to yield.
它是和平、温柔、温良、柔顺、满有怜悯。
It's full of mercy, without partiality, and without hypocrisy.
它是满有怜悯，多结善果，没有偏见，没有假冒。
But the overarching principle of heavenly wisdom is peace.
但是总的来说就是和平。
If we possess heavenly wisdom, we will be peaceful when we serve God.
所以当我们如果拥有这个从上头来的智慧的时候，我们服侍神的时候就会觉得平静安稳。
Demonic wisdom expresses itself through proud words.
那属鬼魔的智慧呢，是在骄傲的言语上体现的。
This begs the question, how does heavenly wisdom express itself?
那这就让我们提另一个问题，就是从上头来的智慧是有什么表现呢？
Let's read verse 13.
我们来读第十三节。
Who is wise and understanding among you? Let him show by good conduct that his works are done in the meekness of wisdom.This verse teaches us that heavenly wisdom expresses itself through good conduct.
那这一节就告诉我们，属天的智慧是通过善行来体现的。
Heavenly wisdom doesn't express itself through proud words like demonic wisdom does.
那属天的智慧，它不像这个属鬼魔的智慧是在言语上来表现。
But it presents itself through the way a person behaves.
它是通过一个人的行为来表现的。
If we go back to the question, how do we serve God with gentleness?
那如果我们回到刚才所提的问题，就是我们要怎样用温柔来服侍神？
It really depends on what kind of wisdom is in our heart.
这取决于我们心中有哪种智慧。
And the wisdom in our heart is revealed when we face friction with co-workers.
当我们面对与同工之间的摩擦的时候，我们心中的智慧就显露出来了。
When we serve God, it is common to face friction.
当我们服侍神的时候，摩擦是很常见的。
But why does friction happen?
但为什么摩擦会发生呢？
It happens when church works are not done in the way that we want them to be done.
那就是当我们想用不同的方法来完成教会工作的时候。
When our opinion is in direct conflict with our co-worker's opinion.
当我们的意见与我们的同工的意见不同时。
How do we react?
我们作何反应？
If we have demonic wisdom in our hearts, we will begin to express ourselves through proud words.
如果在我们心中有属鬼魔的智慧的话，我们就会通过这个骄傲的言语来展现自己。
In other words, we will want to fight back with our words.
那我们就想用我们的言语来反击。
We will want to win the argument.
我们想要赢得这场争论。
We will want to get our own way.
我们想要用我们自己的方式。
But if we insist on doing this, God will not be pleased with our service.
但是如果我们坚持这样做的话，神就不会悦纳我们的服事。
Because by our proud words, we are showing our aggression and not gentleness.
因为通过这个我们骄傲的言语，我们展示的是我们的好斗，没有温柔。
On the other hand, if we have heavenly wisdom in our hearts,
相反的，如果我们有属天的智慧，
when we face friction with co-workers, we will express ourselves through good conduct.
那我们在面对与同工之间的摩擦的时候，我们就会通过我们的行为，我们就会通过我们的好行为来展现自己。
But the question is, what is good conduct?
但是，问题就是什么是好的行为呢？
Let's turn to 1 Peter chapter 3.
我们来看彼得前书第三章。
1 Peter chapter 3 verse 1.
彼得前书第三章第一节。
Wives.Likewise, be submissive to your own husbands, that even if some do not obey the word, they without a word may be won by the conduct of their wives. In this passage, Peter gives advice to wives with unbelieving husbands.
那这一段经节里，彼得给那些丈夫未信的妻子一些建议。
And he teaches these wives how to bring their husbands to believe in God.
他就教导这些妻子要怎么样把他们的丈夫带到神带来信主。
This verse says that their husbands will be persuaded by their conduct.
那这一节经文里面说到，这个丈夫会被妻子的品行所感化。
And through their conduct, they can bring their husbands to believe.
那通过他们的品行，他们就可以把他们的丈夫带来信主。
This conduct refers to these wives being submissive.
那这里说的品行，对于这些妻子来说，就是要顺服。
So when we serve God.
所以当我们服侍神的时候，
And when the work is not done in the way that we want it to be done,
那一项工作没有按我们想要的方式来完成的时候，
When our co-workers are in direct opposition,
当我们的同工直接反对我们的时候，
If we possess heavenly wisdom, we won't show aggression by using proud words.
那如果我们有属天的智慧的话，我们就不会用骄傲的言语来反驳。
Instead, we will show gentleness through good conduct.
反而我们会通过我们的好品行来显露我们的温柔。
In other words, we will show gentleness through being submissive.
那用另一句话来说，就是我们通过我们的顺服来显示我们的温柔。
For example, whenever workers have meetings in the church.
那举个例子，就比如说这些教会的工人他们有在教会里开会的时候。
It could be a cleaning leaders meeting, a working committee meeting, or even a church board meeting.
那可以是后勤组长会议、同工会议，或者是教会负责人会议。
To work as a team, we need to listen to each other's opinions.
要像团队一样，我们需要去倾听彼此的意见。
And we also need to share our opinions on how we think things should be done.
那我们也要分享我们的意见，就是我们觉得怎样可以做好教会的工作。
Because this shows our heart to improve the church.
因为这可以展示我们的心是想要让这个教会变得更好。
But if we find that the majority of our co-workers doesn't agree with our own opinion,
但是如果我们发现大部分同工不同意我们的意见时，
then we need to let go of our opinion and humbly submit.
那我们就要放弃自己的意见，谦卑顺服。
If everyone doesn't agree with our opinion,
如果没有人同意我们的意见，
We cannot proudly push forward with what we want to do.
我们不能骄傲地固执己见来推进这些工作。
Being submissive is not easy.
顺服是不容易的。
But whether or not we are able to do it, it also depends on this third characteristic of oxen.
那我们能否做到也取决于这个刚才所说的公牛的第三个特质。
Because the third characteristic which defines oxen is twofold.
因为第三个公牛的特质是双重的。
When a bull is castrated, it stops the production of testosterone.
当一个公牛被阉割之后，它就停止分泌睾丸素。
One of the effects of this is that the bull will lose its aggressive nature.
它就会失去它好斗的天性。
However, there is also another effect of castration.
那当然，这个阉割有另一个效果。
The bull will lose its sexual desire.
这个公牛它就会失去性欲。
But how is sexual desire connected to serving God?
但是失去性欲跟服事神有什么关系呢？
Let's read James chapter 4.
我们来读雅各书第四章。
James chapter 4 verse 4.
雅各书第四章第四节。
Adulterers and adulteresses, do you not know that friendship with the world is enmity with God? Whoever therefore wants to be a friend of the world makes himself an enemy of God. In this verse, it uses our sexual desires as a metaphor.
在这个经节里面，他把我们的性欲比成对我们的性欲做了一个比喻。
And it teaches us that if we have sexual desire,
他教导我们，如果有我们有这些情欲的话
，It means that we will want to be friends with the world.
他就说明我们是与世俗为友。
Spiritually, the church is God's wife.
属灵上教会是神的心腹。
So if we want to draw close to the world,
如果我们想要亲近世界的话
，Spiritually, we are committing adultery.
属灵上我们就犯了奸淫。
Therefore, if we serve God with a lack of sexual desire.
所以我们要清心寡欲地来服事神。
If we serve God like a castrated bull,
我们要像被阉割过的公牛来服事神。
It means that we will serve God without the desire to draw close to the world.
那就意味着我们不会带着这个想要亲近世界的欲望来服事神。
And if we don't draw close to the world,
那如果我们没有亲近世界的话，
we will draw close to God and he will draw close to us.
那我们就会亲近神，神也会亲近我们。
We will be full of heavenly wisdom.
我们就会充满属天的智慧。
Then when we face friction with co-workers,
所以当我们面对着与同工之间的摩擦时
，and when we don't get our own way,
那我们就不会坚持自己的方式。
It will be easy to submit to one another.
那顺服彼此就变得很容易。
Then God will be pleased with our service.
那神就会悦纳我们的服事。
Today in 1 Kings chapter 7, we learned about the sea and the oxen.
那今天在列王记上第七章，我们学了这个铜海和铜牛。
The sea and the oxen was a giant bronze bull and bull stand where the priests would wash in.
那这个铜海和铜牛，它就是一个巨大的铜碗和铜的和支架，就是祭司要在其中来洗漱。
Every time they prepared themselves to serve God,
每次他们预备自己来服事神的时候
，they would witness the oxen underneath the sea.
他们就会看见铜海底下的公牛。
Therefore, every time we prepare ourselves to serve God,
所以每一次当我们预备自己来服事神的时候
，we need to meditate on the characteristics of oxen.
我们需要来思想这个公牛的品质。
And this will prepare ourselves to serve God in the right way.
那这就会让我们用正确的方式来服事神。
Three characteristics define oxen.
那这个英文里 oxen 的三个品质。
Firstly, they are over 4 years old.
第一，他们是四岁以上的公牛。
Secondly, they are trained to work.
第二个，他们经过训练来用于劳作。
And thirdly, they are castrated bulls.
第三点就是他们是被阉割过的公牛。
Oxen being over 4 years old teaches us that we need to serve with a mature mindset.
那四岁以上的公牛就是说我们要用成熟的心智来服事神。
A mature mindset is forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward to those things which are ahead.
那成熟的心智就是说我们要忘记背后，努力面前。
We forget past good works to avoid causing trouble in the church.
我们忘记过去所做的善行，以免在教会中引发问题。
And we reach forward and continuously improve to edify the church.
我们努力面前，不断的改进，不断的进步，来造就教会。
Oxen that are trained to work teaches us that we need to serve God by following His direction.
那第二个、被训练过的公牛就教导我们，我们需要、服事神，要遵照他的、他的带领。
And to follow God's direction, we need to ask God in prayer.
那遵照神的带领，我们需要在我们的祷告中来求问神。
But asking God in prayer is not enough.
但是在祷告中求问神还不够。
We also need to ask God with the right heart.
我们还需要用正确的心来求问神。
A heart that no longer wants to do things according to our own will.
那就是不再顺服自己的意思的这一颗心。
A heart that only wants to know the will of God.
那就是我们的心要、要寻求神的旨意。
Oxen that are castrated bulls teaches us that we need to serve God with gentleness.
那、阉割过的公牛就教导我们，我们需要用温柔来服事神。
And when we face conflict with co-workers,
当我们遇到跟同工之间的矛盾时，
we don't fight back with proud words.
我们不用骄傲的言语来反击。
But with good conduct, we submit to our co-workers.
但是用好品行，我们来顺服我们的同工。
Oxen that are castrated also teaches us that we need to serve God without a desire to make friends with the world.
那被阉割过的公牛也教导我们，我们侍奉神的时候，不要想着亲近世界。
If we are close to the world, it will be hard for us to submit to our co-workers.
当我们亲近世界的时候，我们要想顺服我们的同工就会变得很困难。
But if we have no desire for the world,
但是如果我们对这个世界、没有欲望，
drawing close to God will fill us with heavenly wisdom.
亲近神就会让我们充满属天的智慧。
Then submissiveness will be a natural expression of our heart.
那我们的心就会自然而然地表达出这种顺服。
Thank God for guiding us through today's sermon.
我们感谢神带领我们今天的讲道。
May all glory be given to God.
愿所有的荣耀归于神的名。
Let's sing hymn 305.